It is a day for updates, my friends. Fortnite had one of the biggest updates they've ever had in their game. If you want to check out that video, I'll put a link in the description. But right alongside that, well, it's Valentine's Day, and Apex is now showing a little taste of what they plan on doing when it comes to putting content on the fly in their game. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Welcome to the channel. You're watching some gameplay with me, T Martin, and a random. I'll leave you guys with the rest of that once this is over. You guys really seem to enjoy the gameplay the other day when we did the update video. We are going to talk about some serious stuff. That's right, data mining is happening in Apex Legends just like in other games. We're going to talk about vehicles possibly coming, TDM, Titans. You heard me right, Titans. If you didn't know, which most everybody does, but if you didn't, Apex Legends is set in the Titanfall universe. So people have been asking that since the day it came out, well, are we going to get to play with Titans? That may be coming, everybody. Drop a like if you guys are playing Apex Legends at all, and let's get into it. Oh, really quick. I'm not going to say anything else about it right now, but I'm going to tell you two things. March 1st, and go blow the dust off my Twitch channel and maybe hit it with a follow real quick. Link is in the description. Now, check it out on the screen. If you have not visited the Apex shop, the store, you should probably go check it out. And for two reasons. Now, some of this stuff's pretty pricey. I'm not gonna lie, okay? But here's why you should consider getting it if you're a fan of Apex Legends. This is the first update, which means if they aren't going to be privy to bringing stuff back and rotating it through their store, this stuff is going to be ultra rare down the line. So keep that in mind. If you're somebody that likes to get the old collectibles and fill up your skins and camos, especially with stuff that should be deemed rare, you should hold on to this. Through the Heart Epic, you can see it in there. It is a longbow camo variant. And then we have Love of the Game Legendary and some other stuff. So if you guys are getting anything, remember, maybe, just maybe, this could actually end up being very, very rare. Now we're going to do a quick patch notes video, okay? Or, well, we're doing the video. Quick patch notes, stability bugs and performance, various improvements and tweaks to UI, extended timeout that was causing players with slower hard drives to crash, addressed a number of client server stability issues, fixed exploit where you could keep duplicating items in your inventory, addressed a number of stability and performance issues, fixed issues where players were getting a gray screen in lobby when connecting, fixed issues where your friends list showed all your friends are offline, that was happening with me, shortened duration of Bloodhound's Eye of the Allfather clones to remain in the world by 1 second. Also, Valentine's Day patch, added Live by Die banner, we talked about, revive a member of your squad between 213 and 219 to earn this badge, and it's Valentine's, so if it doesn't come back next year, it's probably never coming back. They added the Valentine's Day cosmetic, we talked about that, from 213 to 219, the Love of the Game, and the Through the Heart longbow. So there are your patch notes. Now, let's get into the good stuff, okay? And people have been asking, well, is the map big enough to have vehicles? I don't know. The map's not huge, but the map has a lot of stuff going on, a lot of cliffs in the way, a lot of blockage. I don't know, but it looks like they may be coming. I don't know if it's going to be in an LTM or how it's going to work. We're going to talk about that first. Apex Game Info over on Twitter. Credit to them. A leak. It seems like a hover bike is in the making and is only available to developers at this moment. You can see the leaked patch notes. He has limited number of bikes. Ensure the bike can fit in the spawn location. It looks like the devs on the back end are teasing and messing around with vehicles. So I want to know from you, should this be something that's implemented in the core game, or will this be something that's more of an LTM when it comes to the game? But they are definitely doing something when it comes to vehicles, and specifically a hover bike. Now, let's talk about new game modes. You know we're going to be getting game modes. They're coming. We're probably going to be getting solos, duos in the future too. Now, I know Apex is predicated on teamwork, so the three-man team is honestly the perfect balance to me, but people are going to want more. And always take all this with a grain of salt, everybody. These are leaks. Nothing confirmed. Keep that in mind. New game mode, Team Deathmatch. It will most likely be a mode where two teams battle it out until everyone is dead. Kind of like 50v50 in Fortnite. You can see the notes there, and it does. It says Team Death Match right there. Game mode, TDM shared, game mode, compare kills. It is in the game. Now, does that mean it's coming to the game? Absolutely not, but it's definitely something to spark up some conversation. Now, let's go back to the hover bike, okay? Following up the hover bike leak, It seems there will be three spots on it called a driver, a middle, and a rear. It seems you can move spots while in the vehicle. Just think about the airplane in Fortnite. You can move from flying it over the wing, over the tail. You guys can see the notes. You have attached driver, shift from passenger middle to driver, attached passenger middle, shift from driver to passenger, so on, so forth. So if this does come into the game, looks like you'll be able to drive it and your buddies will be able to sit there and ride it with you. And it all goes back to the trios. Okay, the three-man game mode, it's going to be the core mode. That is what they are going to build this upon, especially if they're building vehicles that are going to kind of fit with that, with the three slots, the two driver, the middle, and the rear. Now, let's talk about something that has everybody interested. Titans. Not sure about this one, but it says that if you're in a Titan, you can see enemies from 2,000 meters away. And I don't know really what to take from this. It's leaked modes. This could have something. This could just be in it as a placeholder from Titanfall. I don't know, but it does beg the question, would Titans fit in the Apex Legends universe, specifically in the map, specifically more in the three-man mode? Or could it be something that could be a lot of fun in an LTM? Me personally, I think it would be something that would just wreck the balance of the game. So if we're going to see Titans, I would like to see Titans in some kind of LTM. And the final tweet says, according to this, Titan's default health will be 2,500, but the title of the file is Titan Triple Health. I'm still finding more files, bit bump jumbled. And once again, none of this is confirmed in any way, but it is definitely in the game files, so it's worth talking about. You guys, let me know what you think in the comment section. I'm going to leave you with the rest of this gameplay, see if we get this win, and I'll see you guys soon. Remember what I said earlier in the video. Link is in the description.
Teeny bit worried about getting flanked, but...
Yeah. If a team comes through the actual fortress door over there, we can get flanked. But we know somebody's coming through here. Oh, now they sound like they're over here.
No.
It's pushing in. They're coming one way or another. Dude, if they come through the door where I marked, let's just go straight to the door behind them.
Straight to the what? The door?
Yeah, we'll just come in behind them. Yeah, they're definitely coming that way.
Dude.
Listen to me. They're definitely coming ridiculous. This way. They're definitely coming that way. Dude, they have to come through the wall. There's no other way. Get ready. Might be something good this way. We are such sneaky beavers.
Round 4. I feel bad for these guys.
They have to, right? Or can they zip line over it?
I don't think they can get over it.
Or are they all dead?
They might be dead. Dude, I would be so sad if they were dead.
Dang.
They're here. There was one guy and I wasted an airstrike.
He was the only one that lived. There's a purple body shield in here. That's awesome, dude. Purple
Poor
body
guy.
Shield. Purple, if you need it. Yeah, you do.
Our
need
boy's
it.
In a fight.
You need to come get that body armor, bro.
I will.
What are you doing?
Taking an ult accelerant.
Oh, okay.
Dude, he opened up that door. Thought he made it. Probably had his teammates, cards. He was gonna go revive him.
I'm alive, I'm dead.
Oh, God, dude, that was,
he did,
that was
he
cruel.
Probably had both of his teammates' cards. What is Jaeger doing, man?
He's in a fight, man.
He's pulling a T-Martin.
He can handle himself.
Yeah, he's dead.
Or not.
I'm throwing while I got in that smoke. There's a guy on the right side. Go down in the water. One down. Bubble shield.
I got one as well. I'm healing up.
Alright, they got one down. I'm going left.
10 seconds. I'm going straight up the gut. Team dead. Down one squad.
Oh,
Guy to the right.
He's behind that thing.
I'm pushing right.
Let's go.
Woo! Good stuff, bud.